Have you seen these kind of transitions? Trying to show that before and after the color grading? I mean, yeah, they look amazing, but they can be misleading too. Every camera brand has its own transfer function.
Optical electrical transfer function.
You may have heard of it, but with another name. Gamma, color profile, color science, or some other marketing expression. The most efficient way to save all the data from the scene is a washed out looking image that is meant to be treated by a colorist. It's not meant to be seen by the general public. Let's go inside DaVinci Resolve and start color grading the way you are supposed to. I first need to do some color management. A very effective way is to go to this button, go into color management, and well, this is not color science. It's more like a color framework. So I'm going to select the color managed from DaVinci. Here, I'm going to uncheck this box and select DaVinci White Gamut. This project is not meant for broadcasting, so it's not Rec. 709. It is meant for web. And for web distribution, it is better to use sRGB. And now I can save. So what I need to do is tell DaVinci what kind of transfer function was used. Right click, and here we're not going to just select the color space. We are also selecting the transfer function. We are going to select ARRI log C3. And this is the image I am supposed to start working with. Right click, create a new timeline, and go to the color tab. You may be thinking that you cannot do absolutely anything with this image. Well, that's why you are a professional colorist. And one of the reasons that we make all of this is because this is most likely the image that all the crew on set were watching on the display. So you are supposed to start working with this kind of image. Of course, you have to receive some input from the VP. So maybe they didn't want this to be completely yellow. Maybe they wanted to make this more of a monochromatic image. So we can change that. I can go into the color warper, select the yellows, and drag this all the way up here. And yeah, it now looks more monochromatic. I'm also making some of the oranges become red, so I can just do this so they are more like an orange hue. And that's my result. And actually, there is another way that could be very effective for this clip. What I'm going to do is create another node. I'm going to connect the input right here, decrease all the saturation, create a serial node, and now I'm going to move the offset. And I'm going to select any hue that I want. Now that my image is black and white, I can select absolutely anything, and I'm still getting rid of all this difference in the hue of these colors. And maybe my DP says, oh, but come on, I need the shadows to look like this, with no saturation. Well, that's no problem, my dear DP. I can still go into my curves, Luma versus Sat, select the blacks, and lower this as much as the DP wants. So yeah, this looks great. I like this approach much, much better than the first one. This is my first version, and this is the second one. The thing about being a colorist is not trying to do some crazy node-trees. It means that you have to get the job done. If it is in just one node, that's okay. If you have to create a huge node-tree, well, that's okay too. You just have to be confident in your abilities and trust the DP.